Bribery and corruption have for long been mentioned as the most common economic crimes, but fraud is emerging as the single biggest economic crime in Uganda, implying that the private sector has equally contributed to this sad state of affairs.
If we tell you individual X has X sums of money on their account and these sums are coming from different sources, it's now the duty of the investigators to apply for court orders and now inspect that account. There's an expectation that they're going to use our evidence in court or call us as witnesses.
We see a lot of committees of parliament, in the case of Kenya, county executives, now that we have county governments, traveling all over the world to go and inspect projects for companies that are proposing to do projects.
Commercial banks, telecom companies and government are the main losers in economic crimes and fraud. But due to confidentiality, so as not to lose the trust of customers, commercial banks and telecoms suffer silently while government takes time to punish culprits. And if it does so, the punishment is not severe enough to discourage the behavior. Fraud via the mobile money platform appears to be on the increase, and this brings to question what measures telecom companies and the regulator UCC are doing to curb the vice.
There are conversations within the banking sector, UBA in particular, on cybercrime and how best to combat that. There is a committee on UBA, which we think is good progress. There is a lot of conversation within the mobile money sector as well, because they actually have the highest number of frauds in Uganda.
Another realization from the report is that there is a trend of people forming businesses with the sole purpose of committing economic crimes, partly targeting procurement processes.
All of us have a role to play. Accountability is not only about pointing at authorities. I think as a society, we have a duty to actually inculcate the right values and culture in our society.
Whether we're looking at domestic resource mobilization, whether we're looking at increasing tax, we need to find this happy balance between stamping out crimes, but also increasing the trust of people and really showing them that the systems that we have work. Otherwise, I think that, you know, it's...
Other aspects of economic crime and fraud have been listed as business misconduct, asset misappropriation, and cybercrime, which is likely to be the most disruptive to organizations in the next 24 months. Rebecca Emmanuel for Urban TV.